Last year, St. Michael's University School bidded a farewell to longtime headmaster Bob Snowden as he retired. Mark Turner, a dynamic and award-winning global educator, has been appointed for the position of the head of St. Michael's University School, and today we'll get to know him a little better. Welcome, Mr. Turner.
Thank you.
As we transition into a change supervised by Mr. Watford, Smoo is really excited to greet you in new position
as
head of school next year.
Yeah, well, thank you very much for your introduction, Samina. It's very nice to be here, and I've already enjoyed meeting some of the students around campus just in the last couple of days, and I felt a very warm welcome.
So what have you always been passionate about?
As an educator, I guess I have to say I'm passionate about education and giving young men and women the opportunity to develop their lives, to be able to reach their full potential, and to leave school to be able to achieve the things that they really want to do at university and in their professional lives beyond. So as an educator, I'm passionate about education.
And what was the biggest challenge you've ever faced?
That's an interesting question, because I think challenge maybe needs to be defined a little bit more accurately, because I've had some physical challenges where I've been climbing in the Himalayas or doing a long cycle ride or running a marathon, and that's very, very difficult and very testing. And then there've been other times when I've been challenged mentally, when you have to be confident in your own views and be able to communicate what you want to do. An example of that would be introducing co-education at the school I'm at the moment, at Shrewsbury School. Mm-hmm. And here at SMU, co-education seems utterly natural and very much the best form of education. Mm-hmm. At the school that I was at, there was still a strong debate about whether it was better for boys and girls to be educated together. So I had to present a vision for that and then be able to carry it through.
Each of us play a role in other people's life. For example, we know that you have a wonderful wife, Elizabeth, and two adult sons. So you play a role of father and a husband, as well as for us, you play a role of headmaster.
Yeah.
So what other roles would you consider yourself playing in other people's lives?
Yes, I think as a head of school, then one is always playing a role. One is always setting an example. I think people look to the head of school for a lead and an example. So I would hope to be able to do that. And in my current school, I'm at the moment doing some fundraising for a number of charities that I support. So again, that is something that I've chosen to do as a role model to encourage the boys and girls, the students, to similarly get enthused by fundraising and charity.
How did you achieve such progress in Shrewsbury campus?
Right, well, thank you. Yes, when I arrived at Shrewsbury, that was in 2010. And we wrote together with the governing body, and having had input from students and parents and all the other members of the school community, we put a plan together, having agreed what we wanted to achieve. And some of that plan was about building new facilities. And we've had four really good new buildings that have opened in the last few years. But also the plan was about developing the community, the people that live within it. And that was where co-education came in. And we were also very keen to try and raise academic standards to make sure that the students were working hard and that they were achieving their full potential.
Was it hard to leave Shrewsbury, coming here to SMU after everything you've done there, the legacy that you left?
Yes, that's interesting. It will be a very difficult school to leave. For those people that have visited Shrewsbury, it's a very beautiful place. And it's a very tight-knit community, and over, I'll have been there 8 years, you get to know people very well in that time. So it will be difficult to leave, but we've also got a lot to look forward to. And coming to this school, it's a very beautiful environment. There are some very friendly people, and also I think there's a great deal that this school, SMU, can achieve over the next 10 years. So I'm very excited about the possibilities and the potential for this school. So yes, there'll be disappointment and sadness in leaving, but there'll also be hope and excitement and optimism about what we can achieve here.
St. Michael's University School is globally recognized on a global stage for its academic curriculum, and the SMU Board of Governments is really ambitious about keeping the reputation on the world stage.
Yeah.
So what actions are you planning to take in order to accomplish that goal?
Yeah, well, I would agree with you. I think SMU has a fantastic international reputation, and I've already started to learn about the academic programs here and the quality that goes on. I know you have some fantastic teachers and a wonderful school community. So we will be trying to maintain that reputation and to make sure that it's enhanced into the future. But over the course of the first year that I'm at SMU, I'll be doing the three L's: looking, listening, and learning, and absorbing as much information as I can. Then, together with the board and having consulted with the students, and I hope with parents as well, we'll gather together a great deal of information. And then on the basis of that, I will present a development plan to the board, to the governing body. And that will be an ambitious plan that will involve building new facilities. It will mean raising money for financial aid to ensure that there are scholarships available. It will be about maintaining the quality of the academic program. Mm. And all these things will come together. And I hope that if we can then launch that vision with enthusiasm, that everybody will get behind it, and that in, say, 10 years' time, SMU will be even more widely known internationally than it is today.
Looking forward for it. Yeah. Speaking of internationality and the global reputation, SMU also has a diverse cultural body. Yeah. And just from curiosity, how many countries have you been to? How many cultures have you get to know?
Yeah, I've traveled quite a lot. My course that I studied when I was at university was geography. Mm-hmm. And I chose that because I'm interested in international travel. So I've traveled quite extensively in Africa, certainly around North Africa, Morocco to Egypt, in South Africa quite a lot, places like Lesotho and Swaziland and Botswana, which not many people have been to. And then just recently I've done much more travel in the East, through Thailand, Hong Kong, China, and into Cambodia. And Shrewsbury School has set up a school in Bangkok. So I've had to travel backwards and forwards to Bangkok quite often. So I've got to know that area of the world a little bit. And in the past, I've traveled backwards and forwards to America for fundraising purposes on behalf of my current school, Shrewsbury. But I'd only ever been to Canada once before I'd invited to come to SMU. So I'm looking forward to getting to know this part of the world as well.
I'm pretty sure you'll like it a
lot. We do already.
And lastly, if you had a chance to leave a message for yourself at the age of a high school student, what would it be?
Yeah, my message would be to be yourself and not be influenced by other people around you, to not be influenced by fashion or just following the crowd, but to work out what's really important to you as an individual and then to follow that, and to be proud of who you are. So I think, because I've spent a lot of my working life in schools, sometimes you see fashions and everybody follows the fashion. And trends. I would like to encourage boys and girls, the students, to have the confidence to be who they are, whatever their interest, whether they're athletic or musical, whether they're extremely intelligent or not so intelligent. I would hope that they can develop the confidence to be themselves.
On behalf of the Holzman community, we'd like to thank you for sharing.
Thank you very much indeed, Samina. I've enjoyed it very much as well, and really look forward to joining you full time in 2018.